I've been talking about mastering that which masters you. I've been speaking about it, mastering that which masters you. It is so important that we recognize that God has created us with dominion power. Dominion power. If you watch at Genesis chapter 1 and verse 26, you realize there are two words in that creation command that God placed over man. And that creation commission that God had placed on man is that one is that they should be like him and have dominion. And have dominion, the power to rule. The power to rule, have dominion. And to also to bring things under their control. In verse 28, we see God saying that they should have dominion and that they should have things under their control. Everything under their control. And God blessed them, and God said unto them, be fruitful and multiply, replenish the earth and subdue it, bring it under your control. Just let somebody next to you and say, I got the power, God has given it to me to bring things under my control. Amen. Bring things under. Now, ladies, amen. You have an awesome power to make a fool out of a man sometimes. Amen. It's amazing. Amen. When a man loves a woman, she can make a fool out of him. Amen. Bring him under her control. Wow, what power. Amen. A man feel that he has dominion. And that's what God has given to him, to have dominion. We take dominion and we use it wrongfully. But basically, God has put us into this world so that we can have dominion and that we could subdue things. We could bring things under our control. How do we do it is important. So Jesus is at the pool of Bethesda. In John chapter 5, Jesus is at the pool of Bethesda. It must have been a very sad moment for Jesus being at the pool of Bethesda. Because at the pool of Bethesda, the word of God says, there at the pool lies a multitude of impotent people. There at the pool, verse 3, lies a multitude. Now, as I've told you before, a multitude is a number that nobody numbers. It cannot be numbered. There are so many people that you can't even number them. So you say a multitude. Now, it is sad that this multitude is not a group of people at Anfield yesterday watching Liverpool play my team, Chelsea. And my son is a strong Liverpool supporter. So he was all dressed up with his Coutinho jersey and flaunting himself and telling me that he's going to beat us. And the thing was hot yesterday because thousands of people filled the stadium for fun. I don't know how some people don't have fun. Amen. Ungodly people who have no thought of God is having fun. And you have God and you don't want to have fun. And my son is revving up and particularly they scored first. And he was in his glee, my God. And I'm a little nervous in the back there, but thank God we scored and equalized. He told me that is no goal because the ball, amen, was not heading. He did not kick the ball to the goalpost. He was crossing it. And the ball took the side of his foot and scored. I said, couldn't care less. We scored. And when they asked him after the show, amen, was over, they said to him, Willan, did you kick that ball to the goalpost? He said, yes, it scored. The thrill and the excitement of people gathered together. But this here was no thrill and excitement. The word of God says it was a multitude of impotent people. A multitude. Think about it. A multitude of people who were helpless. A multitude of people who could not of help themselves, because the word of God says there in that pool laid a number of blind people. People who were halt, withered. These people, they were waiting for a phenomenon to take place. They were waiting for something to happen, and hopefully by luck or chance, just one person is going to benefit from it. Just one person is going to benefit from it. And a number that nobody can number, a multitude. But only one person could benefit when it happens. Nobody knew when it will happen, but it's going to happen. And when Jesus got there, I can well imagine, because Jesus, of who he is by character, would have had compassion on those people. Would have felt empathy for those people. But on that day, it was not his mission to heal everybody there. He was just passing through as he was fulfilling his father's will. And when he passed by, he saw a man lying on the ground. And Jesus knew that that man was in that condition for a long time. How many people are in their conditions in this church and listening to me this morning that are in their conditions for a long time? I know I have been dealing with people myself for a long time, and I've discovered that there are some people who enjoy having pity parties. Not pretty parties. Pity patties. There's some folks who, amen, over the years they have found a little corner in their house. I call it the sad corner. They go in their sad corner and I don't know what in the world they look at, but And their children know when they're in that spot to keep going straight. Because if they only ask the question, it might just be the one that will trick them off for some cuss out. Amen. They will get cussed out. They will be told, amen, it's only me alone living in this house, and all they want to put all this pressure on me. Amen. There are days when you're not in that corner, the same question is asked, and you laugh. But you have become, amen, so sensitive to your emotions and dealing with your crisis, so dealing with your pity parties, that you find your little corner. Amen. Oh, amen. That spirit of oppression. Amen. That follows you. Amen. Just comes on you. And you're like a dead lying down there. Amen. Across that mattress. Oh my goodness. And with about 2-3 pillows tucked over you. Amen. Even one of the pillows making you feel uncomfortable, but you still ain't gonna move it because you want to keep this spot. You have become a victim. You have become a victim of your environment. The environment that you live in. And like this man that Jesus spoke about, this man has been in this condition for 38 years. 38 years this man has been in this condition. I don't know how long you've been in your condition, but you personally feel that you have been too long dealing with what you were dealing with. You were too long dealing with it. Jesus, as the word of God said, he knew that that man was a long time in that position. And I got news for you. God does not want you to live in that state of frustration and miserableness. God does not want you to live busted and disgusted as you are living. Amen. Because Jesus came to destroy the works of the devil. For this purpose, the scripture says, the Son of Man was manifested that he might destroy, the works of the devil. And since Jesus has come that you might have life and that you might have it more abundantly, it means that if you are in that position, Jesus is ready to bust that devil's wicked hold on your life. The devil's hold on your life is going down this morning because Jesus come that you might have life and that you might have it more abundantly. Now, the word of God says that Jesus knew that he has been in this condition for a long time. The scripture says there was this man with the infirmity for 38 years. The Bible did not say what kind of infirmity he had, but I've discovered that even though you may have an infirmity, something may be wrong with your life in a particular part of your body, it means that all of you is not shut down. All of you is not shut down. You may be somehow disabled in a particular way, but you are not totally shut down. So it means that God's favor and God's blessing in your life, the mere fact that you have been God created, it means that there are other provisions that God can give to you, and there are other ways that God can work for you for your change. Just touch somebody's amen and say, Pastor is going somewhere. You see, when God created you, God gave you intellect, God gave you a will, and God gave you feelings. And as I would normally say, if you can imagine it, amen, you can make it happen with what God has given you. Amen. Your situation and your circumstances can be changed because all you need is a word from God. You need a God's idea. And when you have a God's idea will work for you. So Jesus looked at that man and knew that he was in that condition for a long time. And that man had gotten, like so many people, comfortable, amen, in the position where he was and complaining. So Jesus turned to the man and Jesus said to him, do you want to get better? Verse 6. Do you want to be made whole? I have news for you. God wants you to be made whole. God wants you to be complete. You don't have to live dissatisfied, miserable, frustrated lives. As long as there's a God in heaven, that God in heaven will deal with that devil. If you call on the God of heaven, he will deal with that devil. If you call on Jehovah God, he will deal with that devil in your life. You must recognize, amen, that the thief has come to steal. He has come to kill, and he has come to destroy. But Jesus said, I'm come that you might have life, and that you might have it more abundantly. I want you as a child of God, or if you're a believer, or you have stumbled into this church this morning, or hearing me this beautiful day, I want you to know that God wants you free. Jesus said, cast in all your cares upon me because I care for you. He wants you to cast them in. Are you ready to say yes to the Lord and cast in whatsoever your need is? It's time that you can tell Jesus about it. You can tell him about it. So Jesus looked at the man and asked the question, do you want to be made whole? Now, I know it's obvious for you to say, yes, I want to be made whole. And you should have, you in your sanctified self would have said, this man should have said yes immediately. But I'll tell you, there are people who are dealing with situations that they have become so comfy in that, in spite of whatever out there could work for them, they're not interested in looking for it. Because they have a particular opinion about how they would succeed in life. And if that has been shut down, they are looking for luck and chance to exist. Amen. Listen to me. You've only got one life on this side of life. You can't take that kind of chance. Amen. If you want the best in this world, amen, God didn't put you here to suffer. Amen. God put you here to live. God put you here, amen, to have dominion. Amen. You have to deal with your situation. Amen. Amen. If life toss you a lemon, make a lemonade with it. Amen. I tell you, if life toss you a lemon, you got to find a way out of every bad situation. There is a way out of every bad situation. That, amen, that you are in. A woman, I was leaving church this morning, amen, and this smiling woman walked up to me. I knew her very well. Amen. I helped her. She came to me and she said, give me a hug. I gave her a hug. Amen. She said, Pastor, thank you. I'm saying thanks on behalf of me and my family. I said, praise God. Amen. I gave that lady a little space in a building I have. Amen. And I told her, I said, Miss Lady, I know you've been living a real hustle in life, but it's time for you to have some change. She said, what can I do? I said, open a thrift shop in this space I give you here. I say, open a thrift shop. I said, amen. See if you can get clothes from different people in different places. And when people come, you can sell it for $5, $6, $10, as the case may be. The space I gave the woman was a real nice space. It was 32 feet by 24 feet. And not before long, that woman's ambition was amazing. That woman's ambition, she turned that place, amen, to a fully stocked, amen, thrift shop where people gave her stuff, and she would go to garage sale and buy stuff and open up an amazing business. She said to me, Pastor, for this Christmas I wanted to rewire my house and to do some little additions and things like that. And she said, I called a garage sale. Can you hear a garage sale in a thrift shop? Garage sale is what people who have good stuff, amen, amen, have some money. But she realized that she'd been packed up with all these things in this thrift shop, amen. That some of it ain't moving. So she thrifted the thrift. And she said, Pastor, I made the money for my, amen, to wire my house and repair the house. And she said, I just wanted to know, I'm going to hug you for the opportunity. I just want to hug you for the opportunity. You gotta look for the opportunity. Jesus is passing by. And people who have committed themselves to Jesus, they cannot stay lying down and let the devil lick them up. Amen. As a child of God, you have to recognize that, amen, that you got to use what God has given you. And since God has given you this, there are three things you must back this with. I'm glad you asked. I'm going to tell you why you're going to back it up. You have to back it up with prayer. You have to back it up with thought. And you have to back it up with consideration. You have to start to learn to count the cost. You got to start to count the cost. You got to begin to deal with the realities of what will happen after that you have prayed and thought. See, many times the reason why people don't go further than prayer and thinking is because they don't want to deal with the implications of making decisions. Because they're waiting for handouts. They're waiting for somebody to help them. That's the man. Watch verse 7. Jesus spoke to the man and said, "Do you want to get better?" The man said, "Sir." He talked almost like a woman there. "I have no man." Some women feel they can't go nowhere because they are no man. Listen to me. Listen, who said you can't go nowhere because you are no man? Some of you have man and you ain't going nowhere. Oh Lord. Did I say that? Some of you ain't have a man and ain't going nowhere because like you have no man. Look, it's right there. Did I say anything wrong? And the impotent man answered him, "Sir, I have no man to put me in the house." No, put me in the pool. Can you have no man? Amen. You're not going to move out of your mother's house. Amen. Amen. Listen to me. You got to, amen, put me in the pool while I'm coming. Somebody always stepping in my way. Our next woman. Oh, somebody stepping in my way. Nah, can I get real? Because this is a real world we're living in. We are there. Hey, amen. You ain't no fake people here. You're real people. Amen. Hello there. Amen. But so then listen to me. So then you gonna remain lying down across that bed? You gonna remain in that corner? Amen. Like little Tommy Tucker. Amen. Amen. You're going to remain in that place, amen, with spider webs all over you, shutting you down because the webs of life is just all over your face, amen. And you, amen, you say, "I ain't going nowhere because I tie up, I tie down." Amen. And you say, "I ain't going to church." So all your life is coming to church. And that man don't mind you coming to church because he know when you come to church, you ain't looking for no man. It's God you're looking for, amen. So he feels safe. He don't mind you coming to church. You coming to church? Oh yeah, where my wife? She's a church woman. Yeah, she going to church. She didn't tell her to come to this thing. I ain't telling her because I know if I tell her, she ain't gonna come. Amen. She's like to lie down across that bed and stay in that dirty clothes corner. The man too. No, sometimes some men, they only feel it's only women. Women, the men are also in that dirty clothes corner. Amen. Some men, they wake up in the morning and all they find is on the street, on the block. And they are stuck on that street. "Hey, Tommy, hey, hey, going on, dog, hey." And that's the furthest they go. Buy two beers one time now. I smoke in Broadway. stuck in the corner of the street. Amen, amen. And man, I'm talking about people with thought. People who can imagine, hello there, people who can create,
They are paralyzed. They are impotent. They are powerless. Amen. Because the devil has them hooked on a life that is, amen, that is down. It's a life of degradation. It's not just sin. It's degradation. It's a life of debt. So he's stuck there. He saying, Jesus, he ain't no man. People always stepping in his way. And Jesus said, can you imagine? Jesus said, my God, this man won't get it. This man won't get it. I asked him if I could help him. And me and all the people, all this pastor on here, all the wise man people business. Amen. And this man is stuck. Stop. There's some folks in there. Amen. And sometimes that's what the devil working you don't for you not to come to the house of God, because, amen, you know, some of you, they know church to be a religious thing and not church to talk like the way I'm talking to you. Amen. Yeah. Amen. This is not in context to some kind of amen church that I brought up. The church I pastored in Diggle Mountain is 92 years old. So you know I was brought up under conservative Pentecostalism. So if, amen, as far as they concerned, I'm a riot. Amen. In my circles, they think he need to be a little more conservative. Amen. Amen. But amen, while you're catching your skin, you think I can tell you, amen, things in a way wherein, amen, you have to search to find out. I'm going to tell you exactly what it is. Amen. Black is black and white is white. I'm going to tell you the truth. Amen. It's time for you to wake up. Amen. Amen. So that's what Jesus said in verse 8. Jesus said to him, arise. Arise. It's time for you to get up. Get up. Can't just remain there. You know, you down there. Why? Amen. You're not getting up and you complaining about everything. Amen. Making all kinds of excuses and you are down there. Listen to me. Amen. If you keep doing the same thing the same way all the time, guess what? You're going to get the same results. Amen. It's time for you to switch. It's time for you to make a change inside of this place. Let's high five somebody, amen, and say it's time for you to make a change. By the way, just stand on your feet and lift your hands and say, God, I lift my hands before you because my help cometh from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. I want you to know that God is going to help you. God is going to help you. They that call upon the name of the Lord, they shall come on and shout, yeah! Come on and give him a praise for a solid minute. Come on and give him a praise for a solid minute. Open up your mouth in this place and lift up your voice and begin to praise God, because the Lord is your helper. You want change. God is your helper. Have your seats. Jesus said to the man, arise. Change your position. As I was saying, prayer, thought, consideration. One of the reasons why people are afraid of the applications of consideration is because consideration is going to discomfort you. Considerations is going to tell you that it's not going to be normal business. I'm at home, and for 12 years I've been watching my garage at home. I have my garage, my carport. The guys who build that carport 12 years ago upset me when they built that pet carport. The A in the roof was leaning like this, E. I don't know if my neighbors saw it, but I keep seeing it. I knew it was like that. And then they were supposed to give me a hip and valley design on the roof, and the hip looked like he had a spinal problem. So it's real bad. It's not as bad as I'm painted. I lived with it for 12 years, but it was in my mind. You know, So I never really sealed underneath of it, because 12 years ago, I wanted to just take it down after Christmas, because I was pushing the house to finish at Christmas, and to take it down, you know, and fix it after Christmas. But after that Christmas was over and that house was finished, boy, listen to me. I said, Lord, I don't like it, but I'm going to finish it this summer. But somehow this season, I said, you see me, I don't want to interfere this now, because, so I decided, I told Sister John, let's move. And not because of that, I just wanted to move, amen, and downsize to a smaller house. So I got a real nice small house. And we had it fixed up real nice to move into last year, November. I told the church that I was moving. And I said, we are moving, and the place was big yard, and we're going to have, I like to party, amen. So I love my members home at my house, amen. And just have a good time, a fellowship. So I said, oh boy, this is more yard space. So I told Sister John, girl, we're moving, amen. November came for us to move, amen, last year. And she said to me, her excuse was, I'm not moving. I said, why? She said, well, you could move. And then my son said, I'm not moving either. So I lost the vote immediately. He said, by the way, you and mommy can move. I am not moving from this house. You see this house? This is my house. I'm going to be living here all my life from here on. So if anytime I move, I'm not moving. I'm staying in this house. So he automatically, he claimed a whole house for himself. So I had to just back off and forget the idea to see if I can get to get them to move. So my wife said, of course she felt bad. She said, I'll move after the Christmas. Now, last year, November, this is November, she's not moving. And the roof is still bothering me after 12 years. Now, I know if I move this roof, it's going to take a lot of work from the carport. So I decided, forget the thing, they ain't moving, and me ain't moving too. I got to stay here too. I need to change up the front of this house. So look at the time I'm doing this. Holidays coming. So I called the workmen and I asked them how much time they can give me to do it. And they gave me the time. I said, okay, I'm going to trust you guys and chance it, you know, because I want to enjoy my holiday. So I broke down the entire front of the house. Man, you should see in front of my house. In front of my house is in a mess. The roof is gone. The walls. The steel's off the walls, and the place is filled with gravel and steel. I said, Lord Jesus. And my wife said, you think you can get this fixed before the holiday? She said, otherwise, see this thing? Nobody ain't coming here by me for the holiday. This place is like this. I said, okay, we're going to fix it. But you know, what I learned out of that, I learned that making this a shift will create disturbance in your life. But if you are making a shift for betterment, you have to be ready to live with the disturbances in your life. You see, many times you want things to happen, but you don't want it to happen to distract your normalcy. No. Any major shift in your life is going to distract your normalcy. You see, you could get your comfort in being where you are. It's not costing you anything. But a shift is going to cost you. A shift is going to cost you. This is a building shift, but it is a mental shift is going to cost you. An emotional shift is going to cost you. Any decision that you make to advance yourself, amen, for better, is going to take some of your time. It's going to take your time. So you got to tell yourself that after your prayer, thought, and consideration, you have to realize, evaluate how long you're going to be in this state and be prepared with the mental toughness, the stick-to-it-ativeness, the resilience and the fortitude. You have to be ready to fight. You have to be ready to, amen, to make it happen. Because things just don't happen. Nothing just don't happen, by the way. Just touch somebody next to you and say, nothing just don't happen. Nothing just don't happen. You have to be ready, amen, to count the cost. You got to be ready to count the cost. I know they're going to hate you. Amen. 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 They're going to hate you. Amen. For making the shifts. There are some people who can't handle shifts in your life. Amen. But you got to make a decision that I am going to pay the price. Amen. Amen. To change. The word of God says that Jesus spoke to that man and said to that man, take up your bed. Take up your bed and walk. And the word of God says, immediately. You got to make a decision that you wouldn't have the time for to change your mind. Amen, amen, amen. I told the man, come take down this before Sister John. Amen, change her mind. Amen. Oh, Andrew started to protest and say, what you doing? Look at the time of that. I said, take it down quick. Amen. You got to make decisions so quick that nobody can change their mind. Amen. You are stepped out in it. Amen. Are you ready? Amen. You got to count the cost and throw yourself in it. And when you throw yourself, as long as you throw yourself in God, you are saved. As long as you throw yourself in God, you are saved. God never fails. Make a God decision. So high five somebody and say, make a God decision. Make a God decision. When you make a God decision, amen, nobody loses but the devil loses. Because God will not deny you. God will not deny you. He cannot deny himself. The man took up his bed. Immediately he took up his bed and he walked. Jesus, neither the man, couldn't care what day it was. He couldn't care what day it was. It was the Sabbath. It was the Sabbath. The man walking with his bed under his arms on the Sabbath. He's walking with his bed under his arms on the Sabbath. He's walking with his bed under his arms. He's walking it on the Sabbath. I can imagine the excitement in this boy's life. 38 years, oh God, it feels good, amen. Because some of you, amen, for 38 years, you don't know there is a movie town, amen. Amen. You don't even know there is a mall, amen, in Trin City. Amen. You've been lying down on that bed. You don't go no mall. You don't go no cinema. Amen. You just lie down there with all that woman worries and man worries and job worries. The people on your job are home for the weekend, gone Las Cuevas and Maracas. Amen. And you used worrying about them lying down on your bed. Amen. That man, amen, he watching all those impotent people and said, my God, amen, favor in fear, amen. He's walking around the place, amen, with his bed, amen. He's going all until he run into some religious people. So, amen. Who like to mind people's business. Like she get a man, look at the hairstyle change. She going out, car pulling up. Oh my God. Amen. 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 The eyebrow shift. Amen. In a different position. Listen to me. You got to change. Amen. You cannot remain the same and expect to get the same results. You got to change. Come on, stand on your feet and let's close this service. You forget those religious people and start to let Jesus rule your life. Who the Son of Man set free is free indeed. Hallelujah. Throw those hands up in the air and begin to call upon the name of the Lord. Begin to call upon the name of the Lord. You are going to change. Amen. Amen. That bed must not master you anymore. Amen. You have to master that bed. That's what that man did. He took that bed and put it under his arms. Amen. And he began to walk. He said, I'm going to master my situation. I'm going to change my situation. It's time for you to change your situation. I want to pray for some people. Come down quickly so I can, amen, pray over you and send everybody home. Come on. Amen. Come on. Amen. Come on. You decided that you had enough. You had enough of staying the same way. You had enough. Enough of staying the same way. It's time for a shift. It's time for a change. Amen. It's time for a change. As you come down, lift your voices to God and raise your hands. Please forget pastor is up here. Amen. I'm going to prophesy over you. I'm going to talk to you. I have to speak over your life. It's time for you to make a shift. It's time for you, amen, to tell that devil you have had enough. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. You have had enough in the name of Jesus. It's time for you to get out and start living in the name of Jesus. Live and not die. Amen. Live and not die in the name of Jesus. Refuse to die. Come on and say, I refuse. Say it, I refuse. I refuse to die in any condition that God didn't put on me. Just refuse to die. Refuse to remain in that situation. Refuse to, amen, to lie down busted and disgusted. Refuse to let, amen, another day come. Amen. And you, amen, you are not getting up to go forward. Amen. This is time for you to get up and go forward. This is time for you, amen, to see a light on the outside that is brighter and better. Amen. The word of God says that God is your sun and your shield. He's your sun and shield. He gives grace and glory, and no good thing would he withhold from you. God would not withhold any good thing from you. Amen. Come on, say it with me. God will not withhold any good thing from me. That's right. He will not withhold it. He will not withhold it. Come on, amen. Let it resonate in your spirit. He will not withhold it. God will not withhold it. Let it resonate. Amen. Let it resonate. God will not withhold it. Amen. I'm on my way up. Come on and raise your voices with thanksgiving. I am on my way up. I am on my way up. I am on my way up. A change is now. A change is now. A change is now. Come on. I believe I can fly. I believe. Receive it. In the name of Jesus. I rest my hands on you folks here today. That devil will not have you in that nappy, messed up situation from this day forward. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray you receive these anointed words to arise. I prophesy on you, arise. I prophesy on you, arise right now in the name of Jesus Christ. Go forth and live. Go forth and live. I prophesy on you. This is the time to get up. This is the time to get up. They prophesy on you now. In Jesus' name. Not bitter. But better is on you. In the name of Jesus Christ. Not bitter. But better is on you. Right now in the name of Jesus Christ. I speak it over you. I speak it on you in the name of Jesus Christ. This is a new day of grace on your life. I prophesy to you, this is a day, amen, of experiencing the fire of God. Fire to live, cleansing fire, changing fire. Oh yes, fire from God. It's on you right now. The fire is on you right now. Yes, the fire, Holy Ghost fire. Holy Ghost fire to burn up every work of darkness and for you to live a whole life, a full life, a blessed life. In the name of Jesus Christ, I speak this grace. I speak this life for you. In the name of Jesus, Holy Ghost fire. Fire. Fire from God. In the name of Jesus Christ. Power from God. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Anointing from God. Receive it. Anointing from God. In the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, the living water, let it come on you. And you will bring forth fruit in your season. A living water to bring forth your fruit in your season. Whatever you do, it prosper. I speak that grace on you in the name of Jesus. I speak that mercy. I speak that grace on you. It's time to arise. Rise and live. Rise and see a new way out in the name of Jesus. I prophesy on you in the name of Jesus Christ. Receive it. Receive it, receive it, receive it. Receive it, receive it, receive it. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, receive the abundance of life, the abundance of power, the abundance of grace to come forward. In the name of Jesus, receive it now, receive it. The abundance of God's grace to live and not die. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, receive it. Receive, receive the blessed hand of. Hallelujah. The blessed hand of Christ. The blessed hand of Christ. The blessed hand of Christ. The blessed hand of Christ be upon you. The blessed hand of our Lord and Savior. Receive it on you today. Change is here. Manifest itself in the name of Jesus. Power, power to live, power to go, power receive it, power to walk out of the clutches of the wicked works of Satan in the name of Jesus. Day of new beginnings, a day of overcoming, a day to reign, a day to rise. Rise up in Jesus' name. I command you, rise up. Rise up in the name of Jesus. Today is your day to overcome. Today is your day to triumph. Receive it in the name of Jesus. A better day is yours. Christ's hand is on you. God, thank you for blessing. Thank you for blessing. In the name of Jesus, blessing is yours. Blessing is yours. Blessing is yours. Blessing is yours. Yes, not another day of defeat. Not another day of lying in defeat. Not another day of power to arise. Live the abundance of God's grace and life be upon you. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Oh, Holy Ghost, thank you. Fire, fire, God, fire, fire to burn up everything that stands in his way. Oh God, in the name of Jesus, a prophetic word now, God, to initiate his move. Give it to him now. Give it to her. A prophetic word to initiate your move. Receive it now. In the name of Jesus. Thank you. Amazing strength. Amazing grace. Receive it to make your next move. Receive it. Blessings. Receive it. blessings, God. Overcoming grace. Overcoming grace. Abundance of life and mercy. Receive it. Arise. Arise in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus, I prophesy life on you. Arise in the name of Jesus. I prophesy life for you. Arise in the name of Jesus. Wake up and see. Wake up and hear. Wake up and hear. Wake up and see. This is your day. In the name of Jesus, receive it. The power to live. The power to overcome. The power, amen, to know the hand of God's blessing and favor. Receive the same today. To know God, grace and favor, life flow through you. Live and not die, in the name of Jesus Christ. Live. Hey, kana mashanda yana maku, matia tayande kasiande, utokoro bosheende. Live in the name of Jesus. Live, hallelujah. Arise and go forth in the name of Jesus. I prophesy on you, amen. Live, hey, in a new day of God's favor and blessing, a new day of God's favor and blessing, new beginnings. Arise in the name of Jesus Christ. And live.
I believe I can fly.
In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Arise and live. Rise and live. Arise and live. Arise and live. In the name of Jesus. Live. Rise and live. I command for such a revelation come to you now. You see a way, walk in it, blessings, grace and favor, live, live, fulfill destiny, fulfill destiny, fulfill destiny. I prophesy on you, destiny come forth, understanding, revelation, enlightenment, power to go forward, come forth on you. In Jesus' name, arise and live, arise and live, arise and live. Mercy on you, Hakanda Bashanda, Ayanamake Adabasiate. Victory is yours. Power to go forward and live. Power, power, power. Power to see new doors open. Power to see new things happen. Excellence to manifest itself. Bless you. Bless you. Bless you. Power to live. Give it to her, God. Revelation and understanding. She can do it. She is going to have doors open. Doors open. She can do it. Doors open, God. Bless her to arise. Bless her to arise. Be strong and overcome. Victory is yours. Victory is yours. Door favor him. Open doors to make it happen for him. Oh God, grace and provision of wisdom for initiative to manifest. Do it for him. Do it for her. Great things to happen in the name of Jesus. Manifest it, God. Manifest it. Manifest it. Manifest it. No container. Don't withhold it, God. Don't withhold it. Manifest it in a great way. Let grace manifest in fruitful living. Live it fruitfully in Jesus' name. Fulfill it, God. Manifest it. Manifest it in fruitfulness. Manifest it in fruitfulness. This is her day, God. I prophesy on you. Arise. Arise.